protect your principal from things that you know about their personalities.
All right, let's move on to some other sensitive issues. It's causing a bit of a stir right now. The Fox News host, Laura Ingraham, she's facing a lot of blowback over a comment she made about immigration, legal and illegal, by the way, and how it's changing the United States. Listen to this.
In some parts of the country, it does seem like the America that we know and love doesn't exist anymore. Massive demographic changes have been foisted upon the American people, and they're changes that none of us ever voted for, and most of us don't like. From Virginia to California, we see stark examples of how radically, in some ways, the country has changed. Now, much of this is related to both illegal and, in some cases, legal immigration that, of course, progressives love.
All right, so what's your reaction to that?
You know, I'm super not happy with that. I mean, I like her as a person, but if you remember Father Tom Coughlin in the 1930s, my grandparents certainly remember him. And, you know, it's the same rhetoric, it's the same sentence structure, and it's the same level of xenophobia that, frankly, my immigrant grandparents faced as Italian Americans 70, 80 short years ago. So I'm not in love with it. I love the concept of America, the ideas of America, and the great experiment of our republic, where we really are, what Lincoln said, the last best hope for mankind, because we have our diversity. We get our strength from that diversity. And one last point, Lee Kuan Yew once said about America, Wolf, that we have such a competitive advantage around the world because you can come to the United States as a Chinese or a German and become a German American or a Chinese American, but that's not true going to those other countries. And so that's a huge competitive advantage that we have versus the rest of the world in terms of the intellectual capital. And I really wish she wouldn't talk like that because it sounds ignorant. And it's unfortunate, particularly if you know your grandparents' immigration story or you yourself are an immigrant. So yeah. I hope she walks it back. I hope she realizes that what she said is it's against the American values that she's supposedly touting.
But does that rev up her that base that clearly so supports the president, that kind of language?
Yeah, you see, so I sort of disagree with about that because I'm writing a book about this. I'm writing a book called The Blue Collar President about my experiences with the campaign and going into those markets and having grown up in a blue collar family where neither one of my parents went to college. The identification that these people have with the president, they're not nativists, they're not xenophobes. I know they're being portrayed like that on the TV and so forth, but it's a very small population of those people, Wolf, that are like that. If anything, each of these people have an immigration story, and they just want what we all want in the United States is an aspirational economy and an aspirational opportunity for their children. So yeah, it may tweak, and it may get a lot of media attention for a small group of people, Wolf, but I really think it's un-American, and by and large, most Americans are great people, and they don't like that sort of nonsense.
And almost all of us are children of immigrants, to be sure, as you correctly